40-30.
And that serve landing a little bit short. I think that's where Boris Becker will get in trouble with a shorter second serve. Leighton Hewitt's return is too good for that.
Advantage Becker.
Benefiting from the fact that the court is playing very firm and the bounce very high this year, so it's going to suit Hewitt today, I think.
Advantage Becker.
Boris really could have done a little more with that backhand volley, but still a screaming forehand by Leighton Hewitt. Boris is going to have to do more with that volley to win.
Deuce.
A wise old bird that he is, gets the first serve in when it matters.
And a hard one as well, 124 miles an hour out wide. That's really hard.
Advantage Becker.
This has become now quite an important game psychologically, because they haven't played each other before, and Becker will want to keep the young man in his place.
First game.
So Becker being made to work hard in that opening game, as he was, of course, in his first round here against Miles McLagan, beating him 6-2 in the fifth. Nicholas Kiefer was a much easier proposition for him. A lot of emotion in that one. Well, his opponent, too, has been very impressive in getting to this third round. Filippini of Uruguay in the first round, in straight sets it was, and then Karim Alami in four sets. Just confirming what talent this young man has. And I was thinking, Martina, a bit of a struggle there for Boris on his serve. At this stage of his career, how important is the serve and how good is it compared to what it used to be?
Well, we didn't have the speed gun when Boris was in his heyday, really. It would have been, then you can compare exactly the MPH. Of course, Boris is hitting his first serve very hard, average 122 miles an hour. The second serve, he hit one at 116. I mean, most guys don't hit a first serve that hard, so he's still got a lot of MPH on it, but he's going to have to get the percentage up a little bit because that second serve will get him in trouble.
Hewitt to serve.
But it doesn't appear like he's lost that much.
Love 15.
Would be quite a good tactic, I think, to bring Hewitt in with those short angles because he really excels from the back of the court. Not that he can't volley. I was watching him at practice against Darren Cahill, his coach, out on court 12 this morning, and he was doing a lot of volleying then.
And Boris hitting another drop shot. It's very unusual to see two in a row. Toying with Hewitt right there. That's embarrassing for the young guy. He's not going to want to see that again.
15-30.
And you've got good odds on that, Martina. The first ace in this match coming from Hewitt, not Becker.
Probably 8-1.
Game on.
So Hewitt being teased with some drop shots, but coping well, coming back from Love 30. And his parents there at the back, very proud of him today. His first appearance on the centre court. Dad Glenn, a former Aussie Rules footballer. Mum Sherilyn, PE teacher on the right there in the white cap in the back row. Darren Cahill, his coach.
Love 15. 15-all.
Boris moving to his right as Hewitt's hitting that shot. Playing the line, down the line passing shot, which is where most of them will go.
So
this lovely return of serve from a deep ball with the two hands, great control, great power, and great disguise. Cahill was out there hitting with him on court 12 this morning. Barbara Becker is here again, and she had to leave all the excitement of that first round match against McLagan. After four sets, she went away. And Boris Becker always one to dive on this centre court. We've seen it so many times in those years when he was winning here. But this dive, unavailing because the angle there, too good.
And Boris just getting his nose right up to the net, which enabled him to get that unbelievable angle volley. Great racket work.
Becker.
And second time Boris Becker attempts this drop shot off the first volley, which is probably the most difficult shot in tennis. For me it was anyway, and doing it successfully. Game point. Oh.
Oh, too good.
Deuce.
Fastest serve yet from Boris, 126 miles per hour.
Game Becker. Becker leads 2-1, first set.
Well, really, Martina Borys having to struggle on both those service games. He was break point down. And clearly, this young man knows his business from the back of the court.
Oh, he's got great ground strokes, Leighton Hewitt. I don't think he has to worry about volleying too much. I think if Borys wants to win this match, he's going to have to hold a little bit easier. Well, physically, this match will wear him down. If it goes over 4 or 5 sets and he has to struggle so much on each service game to hold, it's going to catch up with him.
How big a factor does the physical side come as one's career progresses and gets towards the end?
Well, I stayed in pretty good shape, but what's difficult is you play that one match, but the next day you don't feel so good. And of course, Borys has already had that one match on Tuesday. You know, one day is not enough to recover from that. So it's the cumulative effect when you get older that catches up with you more than anything.
And so many fans for both here. A lot of Australians, or at least Australian supporters if they're not from Australia, as well as so many of Becker's old supporters here, and young ones too. So there'll be no breaks, and it's 1-2.
Love 15. 15 all.
He'll be doing that all match long. He didn't do it as much in the first game that Hewitt served, but now two in a row, he'll be doing that all the time, and he has to. He won't win this match from the baseline.
So
those forcing tactics, taking the serve on the rise and forcing from the net have paid great dividends. 2 break points.
Becker leads 3-1. First set.
And perhaps feeling the intimidation both of Becker and the fact that this is his first appearance on the center court. He was very much looking forward to it. His mother said how excited he was when he knew yesterday that he was playing here. He was speaking to all his pals in Australia who wished him well.
Love.
So another of these gorgeous hot summer days that have blessed us the whole week, people fanning themselves with good reason.
Becker leads 4-1, first set.
So those two aces, his first two of the match, confirming the fact that Boris's delivery is absolutely grooved again. And as you said earlier, he's going to have to rely on that. But I think also Hewitt here is a little bit intimidated. What's it like out here when you are a young player playing a much more experienced one?
Well, my first match ever, I played against Christine Jane Struman on court one. I was 16 and she was, she wasn't 16. I wasn't intimidated because already she was on her way down. This is a much different situation where Becker really still has an outside chance to win the whole tournament. So for Leighton Hewitt, again, like I said, he loves the limelight, but he still might be a little overwhelmed by the whole occasion, playing Becker
time
on center court. Playing Becker is bad enough. Playing on center court is bad enough. But the combination of the two might get to him. Left, second service.
Too good.
Love 15.
Boris Becker just picking up the pace a little bit off the ground, really coming in on a hard ball. Open court volley, no problem.
Well, Martina, I think he's going to have to get a whole lot more first serves in, isn't he? Look at this. Only 31%.
Well, I knew they were serving badly. I didn't know it was this bad. Hewitt has to get his first serve in if he wants to have a chance.
Lovely tennis.
Right now, Boris Becker is putting on a clinic 15, on how to 40. Play grass court tennis. Here he sneaks in because he saw he had hit a really good deep ball and another drop volley. He's showing off with his touch. Hewitt tried to take the net away from Boris Becker with his serve and volley, first attempt of the match, but he's going to have to volley a whole lot better. Otherwise, he better off staying on the baseline.
Love 15.
So there's an indication, Becker trying to live at the net. So a good recovery from 15-40 with classic serve and volley tennis. First set point. So after 31 minutes, Becker tucks away the opening set, and so pleased to see him back here, so many of his fans. And Martina, he made that decision. He was going to play his last tournament here at Wimbledon after so many great memories. Only a seventh tournament of the year. I mean, he'd prepared just about well enough, but he wasn't going to go out on court two the other day, was he?
Well, he promised he retired pretty much 99% 2 years ago, but then he still played more tournaments. And once I saw that, I thought there is no way Boris Becker is going to quit playing tennis on some tournament in Hanover or wherever, Hong Kong. I thought he would get one more crack at it. I was surprised he didn't play last year because he was playing good tennis on clay. Chose not to play, but I'm glad to see him here again. And again, there's no way he was going to lose on that court too.
You've been in this experience, of course, having had so many extraordinary memories here. Was it difficult to make the final decision never to come there?
Well, I was tempted perhaps a couple of years later when there didn't seem to be anybody wanting to win the tournament with Steffi out especially, but you know, I made up my mind and it felt right and I have no regrets. I had my share of it and enough is enough already.
Hewitt to open the second set.
15 love.
This is a must-win game for Hewitt. To establish himself in the match at the moment, he's been blown out of it.
First game, second set.
Back with that in just a second or two. You were earlier perhaps watching the match between Lindsay Davenport, the number three seed, and Laura Galassa of Italy. Davenport duly went into the last 16, 6-3 and 6-2. There was a shock for another seed, though. Julie Allard de Cougy of France playing Alexandra Stevenson of the USA, an 18-year-old. There's a young lady playing her first Wimbledon, 18 years of age, and knocking out the number 11 seed from France. And she's happy. Yeah, very nice. Thank you. Yes, we'll let you know. So there's confirmation of the result. And just in case you're unaware of it, of course, on BBC Two right now, Andre Agassi is playing Alberto Martin of Spain. Agassi's taken the first set 6-2 and leads 2-love with a break, obviously, in the second set. Let's continue with Boris Becker.
Becker has yet to win a point in this second set.
Ouch. 15 love.
Used that slice serve well today, hasn't he?
Well, the shorter that slice serve is, the more effective it is. So you can pull your opponent off the court.
Left for serve. What? 30-50. 14-15.
Boris Becker still getting that jump into the serve and really getting in close to the net on this volley. Keeping the racket out front the whole time. Perfect.
Game back up. One game all, second set.
Well, the signs that the Hewitt serve was improving, but it's going to have to, Martina.
He just has to get the first serve in to keep Boris from attacking his second serve, as he does so well and will keep doing, and that pressure gets to you. Never mind the fact that you have to hit a passing shot.
15 love. Forty love.
Yes, well played.
Hewitt leads 2-1, second set. First set, Becker.
So that's a little bit of encouragement there from Darren Cahill for his charge. Hewitt did play two good service games in this set, and so signs that he's coming to life here and probably beginning to settle down a bit.
I think he was a little overwhelmed by the occasion in that first set. I don't think he expected it. And didn't play the big points. Well, he had four break points and Boris Becker's serve in three different games and didn't convert any of them, whereas Boris only had two break points and got both of them. So very lopsided set on the scoreboard, but it could have been much, much closer.
And in fact, with a bit of luck or a bit of extra skill, he could have won it, Hewitt.
Well, if you just look at break points, if it converts half of them, two out of four, he breaks twice,
nine.
And he holds his serve the two times Becker had, he would have won the set 6-2, just like that. Amazing how close it really is when on the scoreboard it looks like a runaway for Boris Becker so far.
There is confirmation of the fact, and of course underlining the fact that no points, no 2 points in a tennis match are equal, some much more important than others.
And that's what separates the big guys from the little guys. They know where the big points are and play them much better.
Thirty love.
De Palma there sitting next to Barbara Becker.
Oh. 13-15.
Might get a little scowl from Mike De Palma there. He's been coaching him for 2 or 3 years now, hasn't he?
At least that long. There is Mike. Big shoulders. Looks like a nasty scowl on his face, but he is really a nice guy.
No, he's missed.
40-30.
And here I thought Boris Becker was just going to punch this one down the line, a bit wrong-footed. Got a little too cute. Of course, he hits that shot very well. He gets on the outside of the ball really well on the backhand volley, but he missed it.
Game back on. Two games all, second set.
And still the serve continues to function well, six aces now. And that really has been the undoing of Hewitt, who excels from the back of the court, particularly on return of serve, but Becker's been varying it well, keeping him guessing and keeping him under pressure.
Beautiful
open stance forehand by Hewitt. That's how they teach it these days. You get a lot more power that way, and he certainly gets it.
Game Hewitt. Hewitt leads 3-2, second set, first set, Becker.
There are signs that the young man is beginning to settle in on this first outing on the centre court. And he was very intimidated by, or rather excited and fearful, half fearful about playing Becker, who he knew would have terrific support here in his last appearance at Wimbledon. So he was half looking forward to it and half wondering how he'd fare. Well, I think he settled down.
I think he settled down now. Maybe he gave that first serve a little bit to Becker, but so now he has to start one set down, but still very much in this match, obviously. The second set, I think, being the most crucial in a 3 out of 5 set match.
How difficult is it going to be for a baseliner of this type, Hewitt, to win at Wimbledon on grass against good volleyers like Becker?
Well, I think it can be done. Obviously, Andre Agassi did it a few years ago, but you have to be that good. The court is bouncing a lot higher than usually. Normally, the baseliners are out of the tournament but on the first week, and it gets hard like this on the second week, but we've seen it much harder from the start of the tournament. There's a chance, but obviously you have to be very, very good. I think also in Borg's heyday, there weren't that many great serving volleyers or big servers like there are now. I don't think we would have seen Borg win five straight in a row. There had been Sampras, McEnroe, Becker, Rusevski, Philippoussis around. I forgot Ivan Isovic.
Oh, don't forget him. Three finals.
Sorry, Ivo. Becker serve, good deep serve, but Leighton just, my God, what an angle on that shot, no play for Boris.
Well, this has been the problem, he hasn't been able to get enough of those first balls back, just 32%.
And here comes one of those big points we talked about. Boris knows it's big. I wonder if Hewitt knows it's big. That was a good jam serve by Becker. First you have to figure out whether to hit a forehand or a backhand when the ball's coming at you, and then you don't have the room to make the swing. Very effective serve if done correctly.
Three games all, second set.
Seventh and eighth aces, bring him level at three games all, and coming out of that nasty little situation at 15-30 when the double faltered, given Hewitt a half chance, coming out of it well. Well, now, this approach probably should have been a bit deeper to be effective. And he has time this time to make his pass. And is absolutely delighted to have got one. Past Becker today, he hasn't done too well in that department.
30, 15. 40-15.
And well might Mike De Palma have applauded that backhand from Becker, so beautifully struck deep to the forehand corner.
Advantage, Becker.
So the first break point against Hewitt in this set.
Becker leads 4-3, second set, and by 1 set to love.
So Becker getting the break, and Hewitt showing us, I think, that he was suffering from the pressure.
He knew that Boris Becker was going to come in on that second serve. Hewitt's average speed of second serve in this match has been 91 miles an hour. This last one he hit 105, but missed it, because he knew that he had to get a really good second serve in, and that pressure getting to him.
So how do you deal with that sort of pressure in this sort of situation? A young player against a great big experienced man?
Just get the first serve in. That's really the only way to keep a person like Boris Becker from coming in. Of course, if you take too much pace off just to get the first serve in, then Boris is going to figure that out and is going to start chip and charting on the first serve. So it's a bit of a dilemma. So you have to have a really good three-quarter pace serve in.
Time.
And raise the percentage a little bit. Hewitt's at 46% first serves in. That's just, you know, even though he has some great passing shots, he won't be able to keep doing that. I remember one time I lost to beat Zina Garrison 6-3, 6-2, but she passed me like 50 times, and the press said, well, why did you keep coming in? Well, she passed me 50 times, but she missed 70.
Seems to me a little inhibited still, Hewitt, today.
Well, he normally hits that forehand really well and really hard, and I've only seen him open up on about 2 shots in these 2 sets.
Thank you.
What fault? So that time into the hitting zone, just a sway of the hips to give himself room, and then straight through the ball. Too good.
Game back on. Becker leads 5-3, second set.
And Boris playing well within himself at the moment.
He's looking very comfortable. It's playing by memory. I mean, first serve in, volley into the open court, put pressure on the other guy's serve. He's not doing anything special. He's doing it just well enough. He's not playing fantastic tennis, but certainly great. Good tennis.
Let's pursue.
I've never seen Boris Becker hit so many drop shots. They're all working for him. He's putting on a grass court clinic right now.
And Hewitt is facing two set points.
30-40.
Well, there was the forehand that I've seen before, but not yet today, finally.
Advantage, Becker.
So Becker even winning the rallies from the back of the court more than he's losing them, and a second set point.
Deuce.
Rather a third set point saved there.
Advantage Hewitt.
Well, Hewitt attempting to serve a volley here, but nobody would have gotten that volley. Boris' favorite shot, backhand down the line.
Oh!
Becker just hitting a good return here. He didn't expect to hit it that well. After he hit the shot, he started moving in, but didn't need to.
Cute.
So appropriately saving the fourth set point with a fourth ace.
Oh, well played.
New ball, please. New ball. Becker leads 5-4, second set, and by one set to love.
And fought it on four set points that would have made it two sets to love, but how well Hewitt came out of it finally to win his serve.
Well, I didn't think he moved his feet so well earlier in the game. He was a bit sluggish, but he certainly moved well for this one. Becker coming in again. Of course, when you're coming in cross court, you leave the court open a little bit because you have to cover the line. So the cross court pass is very effective if you can get to the ball and hit on the outside. That was very well done by Hewitt. Really moved well for that ball.
So that last game, an important one from his point of view as far as confidence is concerned, because that has been a commodity so far that's lacking. He hasn't been able to open his shoulders and look like the Hewitt we know, and bustling and hustling and really crunching the ball.
Well, I think he hasn't made any great shots, any great points to get himself going, but you have to create that by opening up your shoulders and hitting the shot. That's his strength, hitting that forehand, and we've only seen two or three where he really opened it up. Now Becker serving for the second set. Here, Hewitt has to rise to the occasion if he wants to stay in this match.
So the new tennis balls will help.
And bread and butter here, serving out wide, falling to the open court, even though Boris was off balance, hit a great deep ball.
I don't think she'll have to leave early today.
Yeah.
131 mile an hour serve by Boris. Boy, he really talk about opening up your shoulders.
Three more set points here.
Oh.
So the Becker fans pretty delighted with the situation at the moment after only an hour and 9 minutes. Becker to receive at the start of the third.
15 long.
Finding it difficult to dig out these sliced balls that Becker is firing at him. They're keeping so low.
Boris just hitting a really good return. Hewitt couldn't do much with that. Of course, he should have gone down the line or lobbed. Boris all over that one.
Benefiting from the pressure he's applying, that fourth double fault. But he did well, Hewitt, to keep that ball lower than he has done on some of his passes. Becker has had a field day at balls that have been at shoulder height.
Hewitt.
Questioning glance from Becker to the umpire. Kim Craven, but no overrule, and correct, just lost.
Advantage Hewitt. First game, third sets. Becker leads 2 sets to love.
And Martina, I think one of the nice things always on the middle Saturday here, so many of our former champions are here invited to the Royal Box. And among those here today, Maria Bueno. There she is, talking to Alex Olmedo, both winners here in 1959, 40 years ago. Jimmy Hill there just behind, and if we look along that row, I think we shall find somebody who won it 50 years ago. There he is, Ted Schroeder, the 1949 champion. He beat Drobny in the final.
Well, I never got to hit with Tej Schroeder, but I was lucky enough to have hit with both Alex Olmedo and Maria Bueno. Maria particularly was amazing because I ended up not watching the ball because I was watching her. I had a hard time concentrating because she was so incredibly graceful. Well past her prime when I played with her, but still just such a pleasure to be on the same court with her.
She won in 59 against Darlene Hard, Sandra Reynolds in 1960, and Margaret Smith in 64, so she won it three times. Love one, third set.
Love 15.
And now you see Leighton Hewitt finally hitting a good backhand and getting pumped up. Now he's got something to be pumped up about. He's normally much more emotional, but again, he's not had much to be emotional about, at least nothing positive so far.
That's more like it.
Love 13.
Well, I happened to be in Adelaide a couple of Januaries ago when he beat Agassi, and he was so pumped up on that day and played the most incredible tennis. But as you say, Becker hasn't allowed that today. Well, that's it. And well might the Australians supporters be cheering, because this return of serve is a beauty.
Hewitt leads 2-0, third set.
The off forehand, beautifully hit, and at last he's broken the Becker serve for the first time today. That's more like the Hewitt we remember from Queenslove. That's better.
Oh.
Thank you. Good serving.
Hewitt leads 3 games to love, third set. Becker leads 2 sets to love.
Well, Tina, it's almost as if the valve on the pressure cooker has been released and all the steam's coming out. At last, he's functioning.
Well, I think Hewitt got some confidence because he was down 15-40 on his serve in that opening game of the set, held. Then Boris got down very quickly, but at love 15 on Boris Becker's serve, that was the first time that Hewitt hit a good return of Boris's first serve. He's only been getting about 30% first serve of the returns in when Boris gets the first serve in. And that was the first time he had a really good return, and that might have taken a little bit of wind out of Boris Becker's sails. The crowd was crazy.
Well, I thought I'd seen enough of this at the cricket, but here we go again.
Are these leftover fans from the World Cup?
Well, I think probably some of them are.
They just put the Aussie paraphernalia away for a week and came back out here.
So Becker knows what he's in for now that he's allowed Hewitt to get the Australian supporters going.
Hewitt leads 3 games to 1, third set.
So Becker stamping his authority on this set with that love service game.
And that was a fantastic approach by Boris Becker, but even better reply by Hewitt and a scream to go with it. He is pumped up now, finally, yes.
Thank you. 14-15.
Ominous signs for Becker that the timing now on Hewitt's racket is very sweet.
Hewitt leads 4 games to 1 third set. Becker leads 2 sets to love.
So after a couple of sets when he looked inhibited and finding Becker's tactics difficult to cope with as well, all those drop shots and little angles bringing him forward, now at last I think he must feel he's beginning to do himself justice.
Well, it's almost as if he waited to get really his back into the wall. I wonder if he would have played the same if it was only 2 sets out of 3. Because he really just didn't get going until the second set was over. Normally, at most, you see a player stay nervous for about a set, then they get going. But it obviously took him 2 sets.
So this crowd here today been lying on the pavements trying to get some sleep overnight. The early queues coming in to get the courtside seats, and what a wonderful
time
experience for many of them here for the first time. Looks like a good old Australian hat there. Not as many flies here, thank goodness.
I want to know what they do with the tents and all the paraphernalia they need to survive the night. Of course, the nights have been very beautiful here, so they've been very lucky, the fans. Amazing to see people willing to stay overnight, camp out, just to get a good seat on center court. Fantastic.
So that 4-1 score line to Hewitt, concealing the one break of serve in the second game.
Fifteen-thirty.
Well, you know, a change has come over this match. Ever since Becker failed to break the Hewitt serve when he was heading 15-40 in the opening game of this set, this young man has really blossomed. He got his confidence and beginning to do himself justice. Becker, well, just faltering a little. Very, very good serve at another important point. 1-4, 30-all, that's when you need to bring experience to bear. Yes, annoyed. Annoyed with himself, I think, for not really getting on to that second serve.
Come on, come on, come on, come on. Love 15.
And this is no time to tighten up. This is where the points have been won in the match. As you'll see, Becker winning his mostly from the net. Oh, he's tightened up again.
Love 30.
That was a very nervous looking shot from Hewitt. Got his feet just becoming stone.
Love 40.
That shot just too good from Boris. Of course, Leighton Hewitt taking off a little bit of the first serve and Boris taking advantage. Whoa. Three break points back.
Hewitt leads 4-3. Third set, Becker leads 2 sets to 1.
Well, he leads by 4-3, but my goodness, he's cast away a golden chance by becoming inhibited again. He's tightening up. And his mother told me that this is only the second of the great arenas that he's ever played in. The first, of course, being Melbourne Park in Australia. He's never played on another court like this, and I think the occasion's got to him.
And Australians growing up, Wimbledon is the tournament for them that they want to win more than anything. But with Hewitt, I really noticed his feet just become leaden when he gets nervous. Of course, that's the case with most of us. I know I was like that too. But I really see a huge difference between the way he moves when he's confident and playing well and when he's nervous. I mean, night and day. And of course, with his speed, he depends on his legs to get him in position. Right now, Boris again imposing himself emotionally on Hewitt.
I think of all the players I've seen in modern times, Becker has the most significant presence on court. He commands the scene, rather like the great Lou Hoad used to, the Australian champion of the 1950s. Three, four.
Really great. Look at that ball just off the frame. Very lucky. I don't think this is going to give Hewitt any confidence, but anyway, he won the point. And this choice of shots by Boris Becker, he's tried that a couple times before and worked, but it was on backhand, on the forehand volley, really tough. And the ball was high enough to push it away, punch it away for a winner. Really bad choice, I think, by Boris at this stage especially.
But this time playing the big point, and it was an important one at Love 30, so well, a good deep kicking serve. Still under pressure here though to produce the goods. Not a happy camper.
40, 30.
And Hewitt considers his topspin lob his best shot. That was the first one he's attempted. Very difficult shot to hit, especially on grass.
Game ball, third set.
So Becker is back in this match, or in this set, certainly in the match, he's leading by 2 sets to love, but could easily have lost this set if this young man hadn't tightened up. Change of tennis balls. Well, I wonder if that'll bring a bit of luck for him. Good serve at the body.
And a beautiful cross court by Hewitt. Beautiful cross court by Becker. And Hewitt says, I can do it better than that. Hardest shot to hit down the line off the cross court.
Well, very noticeably, he sort of pushed at the serve instead of hitting it. And he's disgusted with himself. So incredible scenes here from the spectators following an incredible shot.
Hewitt leads 5-4, third set.
Hewitt really up and down in that set emotionally. If you look at the replay here, Hewitt comes in. Of course, it's a terrible lob. But Hewitt doesn't do anything with it, hits it right back to him. Now a better lob from Becker. And here, I think Boris could have done more with that volley. This is where the drop volley would have been appropriate. Instead, he just sort of pushes it cross court. See, nothing ball. And this is the kind of rally that just might relax Hewitt for good. Who knows? Now, of course, it's close again in the third set. We'll see how he can hold up. See if he holds it up emotionally. Very fired up. And Boris is going to have to serve really well in this game because Hewitt is ready.
Second serve. of 15.
And of course it was from this end that Hewitt found some really wonderful returns, just like that when he broke Becker in the second game. Absolutely on the line, no question about it.
And the reason you didn't see any chalk there was because Boris had already aced Hewitt earlier in the match in that same exact spot.
Anticipation from Becker.
And the fact that he got 40, to this ball, 50. Even though he guessed, look at that, he made it look easy. What an angle. Hewitt's going to have to do better when he has an opening, because Boris is covering the net really well now. He's moving extremely well. Game by Becker. He knew that Hewitt was pumped up, and he came up with the goods.
Five games all, third set.
If this set goes into a tiebreak, Hewitt's going to have a hard time winning it. And this is a great approach by Boris. Ball coming away from Hewitt. Becker guessing wrong. Huge point. Huge.
Well played.
40-30. A good rally here by Hewitt, but still, he could have taken an earlier ball in the rally and punched it. He's still playing a little cautiously.
Hewitt leads 6-5, third set. Becker leads 2 sets to love.
And Hewitt keeping the match alive, despite the fact that he's not really, except now and again, showing us the true worth of his ground strokes. He's steering them rather than really clubbing them, as he so often does.
He's not hitting out as much, and I don't feel that Boris is taking advantage enough of that. He was really imposing himself the first 2 sets, really coming in on every opportunity. And here, he's held back some, even at 30-40 second serve, or 40-30 for Hewitt second serve, he didn't come in. And he was doing that so well the first couple sets. Perhaps he's giving Hewitt too much credit on his ground strokes, and Hewitt's not lived up to it so far.
Time.
So these fans really into it, getting the Mexican wave going. And it's always a joyous day, this middle Saturday, when the prices of the tickets for those who have queued to come in are reduced. And it does create the most lovely atmosphere. So Boris, at 5-6, we'll wait for quiet. Oh, there it is.
Love 15.
And like I said before, Hewitt considers this his best shot, topspin lob. This time it pays off, love 15. And I think Becker's using the second serve out wide a little too often to Hewitt's forehand. He's hurt him at that down-the-line return a few times now.
Double fault could not have come at a worse moment. The 8th offense today, and it's produced for Hewitt 2 set points. Well, finding the footing a little bit difficult
30, 40.
At times.
That gets slippery on the baseline when the court gets brown. Although Hewitt didn't look like he was going anywhere, he just went down.
Thank you. Advantage, Becker.
My goodness, he served so well on the big points today.
Six games all, third set, tie break.
And every point in the tie break, a break point, essentially. And Boris has done much better on the break points than Leighton Hewitt. Again, I would give him the edge in the tie break. Although both men are playing very well right now.
Once again, the lob does the damage.
2-0, Hewitt.
And that's where age comes in. I think a younger Becker would have put away that overhead. This time he could only just get the ball back. Cool.
So once again, Hewitt losing his footing a bit and absolutely disgusted about the fact. Couldn't get himself set to hit his pass. Becker ahead now with a mini break. Well, Becker has done enough if he can hold his serve points now to win this match. Just remains to be seen whether Hewitt can find a moment of inspiration.
And to me, this is the point of the match. If Boris holds his serve here and gets up 5-2 in the tiebreak, there is no way he's going to lose that tiebreak. So like in a regular set, the seventh point in the tiebreak, huge.
Good serving.
I was hoping Becker would go down the middle with that second serve. He's been getting hurt on the forehand return.
5-2, Becker.
And Barbara Becker is hurting for certain in the box. 6 months pregnant. This is not a place you want to be at this stage of your pregnancy. Now it's time for Boris to go down. Outside foot slipped. Again, where it gets brown behind the baseline, it's very dry, very slick.
Well, these 2 points on the Becker serve could do it.
That low ball really giving Leighton Hewitt difficulty. He's not been able to deal with it on that two-handed backhand.
6-4, Becker.
So Becker has 2 match points.
Big one down the middle. Here it comes.
Serve that has produced so many winners today, wide to the forehand, and at last Hewitt
6-5, Becker
gets just wide enough to make it, and this is what Becker thought about it. Could not believe it, but it's still match point.
Six-one, six-four, seven-six.
So Boris Becker, for the 12th time, goes through to the fourth round. What a marvellous performance this was from him, starting against a player who was a bit inhibited, serving and volleying tremendously and maintaining his pressure all the time. A really wonderful performance from a man who had a big test in his first round but threw it off and didn't play like a man of 31. He looked much younger today.
He looks a lot younger, played great, and we will see him again, and I'm very happy about that. Well done, Boris Becker.
So 2 hours of skillful grass court play from Becker, the three-time former champion. 6-1, 6-4, 7-6. And this is how it ended. And Martina, what a great thing to see a great champion playing so well.
Well, again, he was playing really well last year. I was surprised he didn't come here, try his luck at Wimbledon. He loved that grass. His game is suited so perfectly for it, and he again played really well within himself. Nothing fantastic, but nothing bad either. Just really solid, good grass court tennis all the way through.
And Becker through to the second week, and all the great players will tell you, and I'm sure Martina, you among them, that once you're into that second week, a whole different feeling.
That's where it really helps, that you've been there before. Of course, luck of the draw helps as well, but Boris has been there many, many times, and he can rise to the occasion. He felt this court the first time he was on it when he was 17 years old, and he certainly is feeling it now at 31. Always appreciated every moment here. And he'll have another one.